Mick, what does my overdrive pedal really need?
More valves, Dan.
More valves. That was awesome. Hey everyone, welcome to That Pedal Show. Dan here.
Mick here. Hola.
Man, that was great.
Nice to have a bit of game.
Yeah.
Right then, valve overdrives. What do valve overdrives do for you? But before that, housekeeping.
Indeed. First of all, thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already subscribed. Also, a massive thank you to anyone that's gone to thatpedalshowstore.com and grabbed t-shirts and merchandise and strings and pedals and stuff that helps keep us going and enables us to do what we do.
Please do that. Please also go to thatpedalshop.com in the US. If you are in the US and you want to buy pedals and stuff, please buy it from there.
Wonderful.
Yeah. If the voices sound a bit funny today, it's because I've had to put some noise reduction on them because we've got a bit of hiss going on.
We do. We've got some volume. We've got some lovely... First of all, we need to introduce that spectacular old thing.
Yeah. So 2 amps today because we want to be hearing our various valve overdrives into a clean amp. Behold, 1964 Fender Vibe Reverb with the prescribed JBL, whatever it is, 130D, F, EFG, CFD speaker, the 15-watt JBL, 15-inch JBL, should I say. And our Marshall 50-watt Plexi, which is just attenuated a bit so we can crank it so it's a little bit crunchy. Idea being we're going to be hearing these pedals into a clean platform and also a crunchy one.
We also have a couple of transistor pedals.
We do.
To just put them side by side until we can get through a few things and differences and whatnot.
Yeah, because that's the core of the question, really. Thanks to Ainsley Lister for lending us the Vibe Reverb and also for selling me this guitar.
Indeed.
Okay. Questions today, then.
It'd be funny when he comes to pick that thing back up. Just, oh, sorry, mate. It's, I don't know where it is. Dan's borrowed it for a bit.
Yeah, it was there 1 minute.
It was.
Gone the next. Anyway, so what the questions today probably then are, well, they're many fold. One of the things that often crops up in the TPS comments is, oh, you guys, you know, you're playing all these tube amps and you like all these flashy old guitars, and then you just ruin it all with a solid state overdrive, yeah, yeah. With a transistor overdrive. Man, if you cared about tubes, you'd only use tubes and blah, blah, blah. So that's one of the sort of issues that pushes us down the valve route. Secondly, actually, valve pedal overdrives aren't that common.
Yeah.
If you think about the great pedal overdrive tones in history, they tend to be Tube Screamers and Fender Black Panel Amps, Stevie Ray Vaughan. They tend to be Fuzz Faces and Jimi Hendrix. Mm. They tend to be all the people down the years who've used normal overdrive and fuzz pedals into a valve amp. But then we have this opportunity to use a valve overdrive or preamp into the front of the amps. What's been your experience of valve overdrives to date, Daniel?
The big thing for me is differentiating between a valve overdrive pedal and a valve preamp.
Yep.
They're very different things. A valve overdrive pedal is made to sound awesome plugged into the front of an amplifier, whereas a valve preamp is meant to lift the volume, lift the gain enough to hit the phase inverter, hit the power stage, and then voila. It's very rare that I find a valve preamp that I like plugged into the front, but there are exceptions. Some manufacturers do make them so that you can switch.
Yeah.
But these are dedicated valve overdrive pedals.
Yeah. I think you could make the case that some of them could be used in the preamp function, but it's not what they're primarily for, is it?
Sure.
They are designed to be used in the front of the amp. Similarly, regular viewers of the show will know that we are massive fans of Simon Jarrett Kingsley products. We tend to like his preamps. We also like his overdrive pedals. We've not got any Kingsley stuff on the board today because we use loads of Simon stuff. Everyone knows we love his preamps. They'd be our first choice as valve preamps. Mm-hmm. And he makes some really nice valve overdrive pedals as well. We thought we'd give some other brands a shot, given that there's a few new things out.
There are a few new things. It's very interesting.
So the question is, you know, what does a valve overdrive give you that a normal regular overdrive give you? And to wit...
To who?
We've been given the opportunity each to choose one normal overdrive pedal that we would, you know, would be a sort of go-to choice. Dan, you've chosen...
I've chosen the D&M drive because it ticks all my boxes.
Me too. I would also choose the D&M drive, but given that he's chosen it, I've gone for the Duelist by Kingtone, which puts a Tube Screamery type thing in one side and a Blues Breakery type thing in the other side, and I find it does most of what I need. So all the time, we'll just be calling back home, so to speak,
sure,
to see what the valve is going to offer us. So, of course, I suppose the sort of expectation, the cliche, the thing that would seem logical is the valve overdrive is going to give you more warmth, feel, all the things that we associate with the valve sound. And that's what comes through in the comments that say, you idiots, how dare you put a solid state overdrive into a lovely valve amp? What you need is valves.
Sure.
So that's our assumption, isn't it?
Yeah. The problem with that statement is that the valve is a component in the circuit, you know what I mean? And attributing a specific sound to any component is folly.
Yeah.
You know, there's a thing that, you know, there's the soft clipping of the tubes. Actually, they're hard clipping.
Yeah.
You know, they clip asymmetrically, you know. But in the right circuit, in the right filtering, they're wonderful.
Yeah.
You know, they're just... It's all about the design. It's all about the sum of the parts.
And these devices that we use in front of guitar amps are there to enhance the guitar amp, not to change it, not to completely get rid of what the guitar amp is doing. It's to enhance it and to push it and to push all those things that we really like to a new height.
Yeah.
Clearly not everything with valves in it is great. Mig Jets, for example, quite good for buzzing around, not so good for playing your guitar through.
Very good, very good.
Where do you want to start then, mate?
I reckon we should start at the tube driver.
So do I.
Yeah.
So we bought this recently off a lovely chap who also sold us the custom shop bass breaker. And he said, oh, I've got a few pedals for sale as well. And I said, what you got? He said, got this. I'll have it. So BK Butler, Tube Overdrive, famous Y Dan.
Well, wow. David Gilmour. I think Eric Johnson's probably one of the most famous users of them.
Yeah.
Wonderful, wonderful thing.
Yeah. Early Tube Overdrive pedal, mains powered, sold under a bunch of brands over the years. BK Butler built them originally. I think they ended up as Dean Markley for a while. And I do believe BK Butler is still making them.
Oh, right.
Yeah. So
he signed this one.
He signs them all, apparently.
Does he?
Yeah.
If you can find an unsigned one, it's worth an absolute fortune.
Yeah, like Jim Marshall posters. So this is kind of interesting. Yeah, let's have a listen
to it. The only time I met Jim was early 1 AM, and he was there getting all the posters ready.
Signing a poster.
Up. Yeah.
Okay, we'll give you a listen to both the amps. Dan, if you play... well, I'll tell you what they are after I press the button.
Okay.
That was the Fender. Actually, if you hear it with the Strat, it's a bit cleaner than that. Fighting with tuning a bit today. Here's the Marshall then. Deliberately hairy, overdriving, a little bit raucous around the edges, because what we want to hear is the difference that the pedals make. Okay, start with the Fender then. I'll switch the tube driver on while he's playing, and you can hear what happens. Quite hard work, the tube driver.
Yeah, rich, creamy goodness.
Sounds
it's very. So the pots have got sort of indents, so they click, and one indent is a big movement.
Most people who use them tend to run the EQs pretty low.
Right.
I've got a feeling Eric Johnson runs them off.
Right.
Or at least pretty low. So, do you like that, Dan?
It's rich, creamy goodness.
Okay. Shall we see? Let's just have a listen to the D&M drive. And just see how a million miles away or not we are.
Okay.
I'll turn both sides of the D&M drive on because I think that's kind of where we are. Right, tube driver.
D&M feels more direct.
Yeah.
And has got that lovely mid.
Not as squishy.
Not as squishy. Yeah. Yeah, they're different, but I think they both sound great.
They do. One thing I like about the tube driver is it does give you some of that kind of crapping out, especially in the bottom end. Let's try it with the Strat set before we go to the Marshall. Feels different.
Yeah, it's lovely.
I'm going to switch over to the Marshall, and I'll just turn the guitar down a little bit so you can hear what happens when you get off of the volume on the guitar. Struggle a bit with that in the Marshall.
Sure.
You've got to commit to that, haven't you?
You really do.
And on a good day, I can commit to it. And on some days, I'm a little bit like, eee! Yeah, man. It definitely, conveniently enough, sounds and feels tubey, doesn't it?
It sure does. There's a chew to it.
Do you like it?
Yeah, I do. Very much.
How much gain has it got? Go on.
Oh, I think, yeah, loads. And there's also a bias control on the back.
Yeah, yeah.
It's really cool.
It's really cool. It's a very different experience than the D&M drive, certainly than the Dualist. I mean, the Dualist is going to sound, in this setting, tube screamery. Interesting about that is with the EQ set that way, it does have a real low mid push.
Right.
I wonder if that's one of the reasons Eric Johnson likes it so much.
Likes it.
Don't know if it's still a current thing for him.
Yeah. Interesting. Because that EQ is so powerful. I expect there's a lot of different sounds in there.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I mean, just fundamentally, it sounds superb, I think. I love the chewiness to it.
I think valve overdrive one, normal pedals nil so far for me.
Okay.
How do you feel about that?
Agreed.
Just, you know, for a ridiculous generalization.
Yeah. Yeah.
Where are we going next then?
Let's go to the Kaluna. So we've been using the Valbrook delay pedals for a while on the show.
Space time.
And it's such a, they're fantastic. This is the Kaluna, his high voltage tube driver. And I was told about this by our dear friend Owen Barry.
Mm.
He says, man, you got to try out that thing. And he's using that pedal on his board at the moment, playing with the Chicks.
Nice.
Yeah.
Formerly different kind of Chicks.
Indeed.
Now just the Chicks.
Just the Chicks.
All right. So this is, I mean, what we should have said is all of these pedals are running high voltage valves inside them.
Indeed.
Mostly 12 AX7s, CC83s, with the exception of the Love Bomb, which is not that. It's a different kind of small preamp tube.
Right.
Kaluna then.
Kaluna.
Absolutely loads more high-end in that.
Yeah.
I don't know whether that's just an EQ thing. Thank you.
Man, I tell you what, I mean, the clone is fantastic. The duelist stacked is amazing.
Tremendous amount of fun. Again, I mean, I was hammering away on some chords there just to sort of give the full fat approach. I'm gonna just, this is, guitar is in E flat. I'm not massively familiar with it. I'm just gonna switch to some humbuckers a minute.
Nice.
And just mess around with the controls. I do love E flat, but it is a bit of a challenge when you're trying to.
It's very slinky.
When you don't play in it every day, it's hard to find a like grounds for comparison.
Yeah.
It's like a normal context. So let's try some humbuckers. Speaker is getting me right in the ear hole.
Marshall's was doing the same to me.
That is a loud speaker. Really nice. It's one Marshall. That's excellent.
It is wonderful.
That is really, really nice to play.
Yeah. It's the EQ on all this, on all the valve pedals is super interesting.
Yeah, yeah.
Because it's part of the gain stage of the pedal.
Yeah.
You know, and so it's not just adjusting frequency. Really cool.
Really cool. Okay, let's go Black Star then. This is the Department 10, I don't know, probably as much as a year ago, maybe even more.
Right.
Black Star came out with their Department 10 pedals, the simplest of which is a single boost with no clever business in it.
Oh, that thing's fantastic.
Yeah, this adds some clever stuff. If you want to learn about that clever stuff, hit up the Black Star website and check out some of the features there. It's got a USB port, you can do things. It has a direct out if you want to go straight to desk via XLR. We're going to just concern ourselves with what's here on the top panel.
Very good.
Which is two sides of overdrive.
Right.
I think the one on the left is sort of boosty overdrive, the one on the right is higher overdrive.
Okay.
And we've got a bunch of options, as you can see. Daniel. Start with the bender again, shall we? Thank you. Lots and lots and lots of crunchy, good, ampy.
It sounds excellent. Really excellent. That might be my fave thus far. It's
certainly the most tweakable.
The two channels is very, very cool.
Yeah, and there's two gain options on each channel, so you can have it clean. We started off like a clean boost, really, and then ended up at really, really, really heavy overdrive. And just... again, to say there are lots more options via the app they've got and other stuff, which is not really our world. So we're just going, what's on the top panel there?
Super cool.
Super cool. Super EQ cool. Is right where you want it.
EQ is spot on.
Blackstar, since inception, has had its ISF control, which is, I don't know, broadly more American, broadly more British sounding.
Okay.
It's a little more complex than that, but you can sort of, it's a master EQ to... shift the range of dominant frequencies, so it's kind of more mid, more midly or more bassy and trebly.
Wasn't ISF a 90s dance band?
You're unbelievable. Yeah, lots of like there.
They sing a song about cows as well. Anyway, yeah, it's fantastic.
Lots of like there. Let's just have a listen to that in comparison with the Dualist and the D&M drive then. Dan?
I'm scared now.
Thank you. there is definitely something more familiar about the regular overdrive pedals.
There is.
In the way they put the mid-range across, yeah. The way they're slightly smoother sounding. Mm. What I like about all the valve overdrives so far is that they're hanging it out there a bit more.
Right.
The bass is a bit flubbier here and there, certainly yeah. on the tube yeah, driver. Yeah. It was definitely fuller on the Kaluna. The treble frequencies stay kind of present mm. and expressive on the edge of the pick.
Mm.
No doubt you could affect all of this with EQ and gain levels, but yeah, there is something, dare we say, more organic in the presentation so far.
It's very nice.
I'm actually surprised at what's happening into the Marshall. Right. I thought it would be an ungodly mess.
Oh, wow, okay.
Just because it's overdriving a bit more, and when sure. you stuff loads of gain and extra bottom end into that,
yeah.
it's kind of...
No, it's holding together.
It really is.
Yeah, sounding lovely.
Okay, double-decker then, Gurus. You might remember Gurus for doing a really nice Ecorec type pedal.
Yes.
A few years back.
Yes.
Italian company. So this is a somewhat similar to the Department 10 Blackstar, is a dual-sided. And I think they're very much going after the Crank Marshall sound with this.
Okay.
I think is the case. I'll go first this time, Dan.
Be my guest.
I'm finding a bit hard actually today. I'm hot. And it's loud.
You're on fire, young man, is what you are. Ow!
It's like relentless overdrive. What could be worse for a guitar player, eh?
Very Marshall-y.
Sounds glorious,
yep.
I think, but it's a sound that I'm definitely not familiar with so okay. much in terms of feel.
Right.
Which is not to say, I hope it sounds okay, but I am struggling with what to play.
Okay.
Because it's not a sound that is in my...
wheelhouse.
...vocab.
Okay.
See what you think. Yeah, I was struggling with the higher gain ranges of it because I was losing any feel. So I turned the gain right down.
Sure.
Gave you some space to work in.
Yeah.
It's easier then, I think.
Yeah.
And then we had a quick through all the others, with the exception of the Love Bomb, which we'll come on to in a minute.
So, impressions thus far, there's, like you said before, there's a familiarity. I think the Duelist is absolutely superb. There's a familiarity with the solid state stuff.
Yeah. Surprise, surprise, feels more like an overdrive pedal.
Yeah. But I think, like, into the amp that's sort of limiting a bit, I dig in and it just goes blah. Whereas there's a squishiness to the vowels that, especially the tube driver, actually.
It's the most, isn't it?
Yeah, it has the most squish.
Might be to do with how we've got the bias
set up.
I don't really understand how it works, so it's at 2 o'clock where everything sounds best.
Yeah, but I'm super impressed. I think they all sound fantastic.
Yeah, because it's fair to say, you weren't expecting this, were you?
No.
You were expecting them to all be a bit rubbish because it's too much going into the front of an amp.
I wasn't expecting them to be as good as they are.
Yeah. Let's listen to the Love Bomb then. Now, the reason we've left this till last, we've got a bit of a power issue and we've been struggling to get it quiet along with all the others as an earth issue. So we're just going to plug it in now and get going on that vein. We're going to stick with the Marshall. We think part of the issue might be with the Fender because it's a really old amp and
we're not really sure. Transformer and all that stuff.
We've tried to figure it out. We can't. So you'll just hear it through the Marshall. This is a friend of ours, Gareth, who is a really, really brilliant producer. And he teamed up with a friend of his. I don't suppose you brought the paper in. No. And I'm sorry, we can't remember the friend's name. Who's the engineer?
Engineer friend.
Yeah. And they've collaborated on this. As you can see, they've gone for an unimposing case. Size. What I like in principle about this is it has a bunch of controls on it that we don't normally see on overdrive pedals.
Right.
And by looking at the pictures, you can tell at the controls, you can tell Gareth is a producer.
Yeah, totally.
What have we got? High and low pass filters. We've got power sag. We've got drive. We've got bias.
Yeah.
Similar to the tube driver. But the low and the high pass filters stepped thereof.
Yes.
This
yes.
is obviously a shaping device.
Yeah.
I shall put down the Lester. Daniel, help us rock.
Thank you. How it looks.
It sounds utterly massive.
It's unbelievable.
The Kaluna sounds massive. In fact, they all have the ability to sound massive. What I like about that is I was in the middle part of Dan's playing there. I was turning it on and off, and it was almost like what you couldn't tell if it was on and off. Yeah. And I was doing that just to see
how neutral
it was. Because what did we hear there? We heard that the standard overdrive pedals are the ones that change the tone the most.
Yes.
In terms of the basic EQ of the thing, right?
Yep.
Sort of stands to reason in a way, because all you've got is a single tone pot, whereas on all of the tube or valve overdrive pedals, well, pretty much all of them, you've got complete EQ.
Mm.
And that's really important with a valve overdrive, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because of the nature of the overdrive at different frequencies. Some of those extra controls on the Love Bomb, particularly the power sag and the bias, take a bit of getting used to.
Sure.
And they seem subtle in their operation, but I think those are the controls where you go, just need
a bit. Yeah, okay.
Like, I don't want a whole load more bass. I don't want to. It's a feel thing.
Just need to open it up a little bit in a certain area.
It's completely a feel thing. Can I just try some humbuckers with
please.
It a sec? Just want to hear how it reacts to the humbuckers. And I need some help.
Thank you.
flipping heck.
Yeah. Big.
In every way.
We often talk about fidelity. One of the things we love so much about the Chase Bliss Automatone preamp, some other pedals that we could probably mention. It's definitely the case, I think, with the standard overdrive pedals that when you've got a huge, great, dynamic, open sound with all the frequencies there, the pedal necessarily closes it in a bit. That's what a lot of people don't really love about overdrive pedals, especially if they really love the core tone of their amp.
Yeah.
To a different degree, I think all of the valve overdrive pedals that we've played today do that less.
Sure.
The Love Bomb does it the least.
Yeah.
Would you agree?
Absolutely.
It has the highest fidelity.
Yeah.
I don't think there's any doubt about that.
No. It's amazing.
If you want that. I think the Tube Driver maybe has the least.
Mm. Yeah.
It's the closest to a normal overdrive pedal, and yet it still has
a squishiness and the saggy thing. Yeah.
This is where the ridiculous adjectives start coming out, like squishy.
But this is the thing, right? So if you imagine, we've got 1, 2, 3, there's 4 valve overdrive pedals there that use the same valve.
Yeah.
They all sound vastly different.
Completely different.
Right? So it's about the design. And like the Tube Driver, that's a sound that you've heard on so many albums. You hear it, it's like, oh, okay, and it's instantly recognizable.
Mm.
The Kaluna and the Dual Drive could almost be used, they're so flexible, could almost be used for anything. Could almost be used just to beef up a clean sound a little bit or to a heavy distortion.
Mm.
The Double Decker for me is a bit more narrow focused for that higher gain, tighter tone.
I have to say I preferred it hands down with the gain lower.
Yeah.
I think as the gain gets up, it started to get a bit confused. Might be that with some combination of the other controls on there, you can dial some of that out. But I really liked it in the low.
I loved that.
The lower gain.
Spectacular.
Yeah.
Love Bomb for me, though. Yeah. It really shows off how good Gareth's ears are.
Yeah.
You know? But whenever that was on, it's adding something
massive.
Really fantastic. How impressive.
I don't think for a second Gareth is expecting anyone to put it on their pedal board. Or if they are, they're going to need a whole pedal board for it because it is slightly large. I think its life may predominantly be in studios and recording, but I guess you could use it live.
Man, I might have a go.
If you were a minimalist, that and a delay pedal.
Yeah. You could see, White Stripes guy out there with just that and his Memory Man.
Yeah.
And just wicked.
Yeah, interesting. So, I don't know whether it's because I'm a bit tired. I don't know whether it's because of what. I was struggling to play a bit today. So I don't know if there's a feel thing, if it's a volume thing, if it's a what. I didn't feel as home, as at home as I do with my normal collection of solid state.
Yeah.
Boxes.
Yeah. Well,
could be the unfamiliar amp. All of the above.
All of the above.
But tonally, really, really, really enjoying everything that's going on there in terms of detail and fidelity and all of that.
Wonderful. How interesting. Cool.
So, what does the valve overdrive give you? Gives you that.
Yeah.
Do you like that? Be super interested to hear what you think in the comments.
Indeed. Love to hear about your rigs and how you're running your valve overdrive pedals into one rig. Really cool. Thank you so much for watching. Really hope you enjoyed that. Again, please subscribe if you haven't already subscribed. A massive thank you to our patrons on Patreon.
Yes, thank you very much. You'll get some of what we do as a podcast, certainly the VCQ every Monday. We also do regular giveaways to our patrons. So if you like the sound of that, hit up patreon.com/thatpedalshow.
Indeed. And again, a massive thank you to anyone that's gone to thatpedalshowstore.com and grabbed some merch, grabbed some t-shirts and guitar pedals and strings and
all of that stuff.
All that stuff.
Similarly, if you're in the US and you want to buy some pedals, head to thatpedalshop.com where there are pedals, amps, accessories, and a whole bunch of information. So go there. It helps us greatly.
Indeed. A massive thank you to our preferred retailers in the UK and Europe.
Anderson's Music of Guildford in Surrey.
Yes, lovely, lovely chaps they are too. And our dear friends in Australia.
Would be Pedal Empire of Brisbane in Queensland.
Lovely.
Yes, I've decided, Dan, we're going to make an end thing so we don't have to do this every week.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that'd be good, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
I think we could do it with flashy graphics and like be really 21st century about it.
Okay. Let's do 20th century about it.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
That's more us, isn't it?
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Fantastic. We hope to see you on Monday for viewers' comments and questions where we can discuss all this or anything else that's on your mind.
Indeed.
Lovely. Have a great day. We'll see you soon.
Bye.
Bye.